Good morning, South. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance with select senior athletes.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands.
One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We'll hear more from them later in the show. Good morning once again, and welcome to the Falcon Report for this Friday, the 16th of April, 2021, a day A2. I'm Aiden Andres. It was a busy week for South's honor societies, as a string of ceremonies were commenced throughout the week to welcome a new wave of inductees. We'll turn the time over to the Falcon Report's Pahul Sandi for further details.
This week, our highly accomplished Falcons were inducted into their respective honor societies, reflecting years of hard work. Kicking off on Monday, inductions were held into each one of the academic honor societies, varying from language, occupational, science, history, and mathematics honor societies. Starting with opening remarks from Ms. Josephine Evola and Ms. Maureen Henry, students were welcomed and stood for the Pledge of Allegiance. Following this, the vice presidents of each academic honor society shared the five pillars of the academic honor society, of which each inductee should stand by. Subsequently, the president of each honor society then commenced the induction of each accomplished student, the names of each student being called either from remote attendance or in person.
Faculty, students, parents, for all being here tonight. Now, I would like to announce each of the new inductees.
As the ceremony came to a close, with the advisors and inductees reading the Honor Society Pledge. In addition to this commemoration, just this Wednesday, our younger Falcons' educational successes were acknowledged as they were inducted into the Starfish chapter of the National Junior Honor Society. Starting off with opening remarks from each of the officers, the National Junior Honor Society's Starfish story was told. As the story of a young man, ever so slightly, saved starfish on a beach by connecting them back to the ocean. As each officer gave the five qualities held in the Honor Society, the candle lighting ceremony began, as each officer lit a candle with each quality. With the names of each honorable student being called, a candle was symbolically added to the induction table, representing the qualities of each new Honor Society member. For the Falcon Report, I'm Pahul Sandi.
Congratulations to all inducted! It was a historic day for South's Quiz Bowl team, who swept away the competition this past Wednesday to advance to the Long Island Finals next week. Aiden Dombrowski joins us with further details. Aiden?
This Wednesday, members of its academic triumphantly competed in their playoff matches for Regional Quiz Bowl. After both the varsity and junior varsity placing in the top 10 of all Long Island teams, the members secured their spot in a round robin, where they each faced three fierce opponents. The varsity team was able to establish a commanding lead over every single team they faced. Through lightning quick buzzes and consistent communication, the team was able to overcome all of their opponents, winning against the undefeated South Side, the second-ranked varsity team on Long Island.
Naval battle where Octavian defeated Anthony and Cleopatra.
Actium, answer.
You got nine of those.
Go.
The varsity team was not alone, as junior varsity similarly finished undefeated. In their final match, the team was able to erase a 15-point deficit after a swift comeback in the final four questions of the match, securing their victory over Syosset, the second-ranked JV team in the league.
Trigonometric function, whose derivative is the secant squared. That is Z-Lin.
Tangent.
Yes.
Yes!
Let's go.
Oh my god!
Coming out on top, the members will advance to fight for the next title of best team in Long Island next week. Wish them luck. For the Falcon Report, I'm Aiden Dombrowski.
Senior athletes have been making the most of their opportunities on the field. We've had a plethora of 2021 athletes scoring clutch goals and making headlines. And this week on the Falcon Report Senior Spotlight, Hamid Abdul talked to just a few of them. Hamid?
I'm here now with Haley Roberts, one of South's senior soccer players. So Haley, has playing at a different time of year changed anything?
Hi, yes. Of course, this time of the year is a bit warmer than the fall. But also, since COVID, we're not in the best shape, so there have been a lot of injuries, which has definitely affected our team.
All right, and what's one of the biggest things you'll take away from playing?
With South, you definitely learn how to play with your team and how to fight till the end, so that's one of the things I'll take with me forever.
Any plans of playing in the future?
Yes, I've signed to play soccer at Binghamton University, and I'm very excited.
I'm here now with Yasir Shahbaz Allah, Newsday's top player. So, Yasir, do you think playing at a different time of year has changed anything about football for you?
I do. I think that, for one, the weather is a lot different. And two, well, not really for the seniors, but the juniors and sophomores, I think, you know, playing in March and April and then having a comeback in fall
Newsday top player is a pretty big deal. How did you find out and react to it?
I found out through Coach Gus. Coach Gus sent me the article, let me know everything that happened. You know, individual awards come here and there, but as a leader on this team, we're really focused on it.
Alright, thank you so much for your time. We wish you the best. Back to you, Aiden.
When the Falcon Report returns, we'll hear far more about music around the world. But first, a bird's eye view of the softball field, nearly ready for the start of the spring season. The Falcon Report will be right back. Chorus classes of Mrs. Rita DeFano took a virtual trip around the world. But welcome to Falcon Report's John Stephen Lennon's with far more.
Taking advantage of the benefits from online learning, students in Mrs. Rita DeFano's chorus class embarked on a virtual journey around the world. To kick off the expedition, students started by discovering a compelling selection of countries around the globe, including Senegal, Spain, Pakistan, and other countries. With each student picking a country, a period of thorough learning and observation was then commenced, where interesting learning topics such as religions, traditions, or cultures were explored within each country. Taking roots from their chorus class, students then uncovered a famous song and artist from each country. While they recognized artists in songs such as Cubanishwul's Vivian or Somos el Mundo, a popular Spanish song rendition of We Are the World, were analyzed by each individual student. This allowed for further comprehension of the diverse cultures and musical creations they might find around the world. For the Falcon Report, I'm John Lennis.
A mixture of rain and clouds has riddled this week. However, there has been some sunshine to celebrate. Let us turn to this week's weather expert, Aaron Singh, for an update on the weatherly situation. Aaron?
We will celebrate that sun once more, but let's get through today first. Today won't have much sun and we'll see temps in the 50s. Tomorrow morning will give way for sunshine and higher temp in the 50s. We'll get the best of both days on Sunday with a mixture of sun and clouds and not much chance of rain. But the dry won't last long as we expect showers again for the early part of next week. Enjoy the sun when you can. Back to you, Aiden.
And through rain or shine, there were some hard-fought battles on the football and soccer fields last Friday. The Falcon Report sports producer Kibwe Basdeo has the stories.
Sure right about that, Aiden. The football team racked up a huge win against Hewlett on the road last Friday. Both teams' offenses got off to a slow start as neither of them scored a point in the first quarter. In the second quarter, senior Yasir Shabazz-Ola scored two touchdowns to go along with two two-point conversions to put the Falcons up 16-8 going into half. In the third quarter, Shabazz-Ola found his way to the end zone again for his third touchdown of the game.
Again, a man to beat, he's able to do it, and he just dances in. I mean, that's how electric he is.
Giving the Falcons a commanding 24-8 lead. With Hewlett's offense gaining slightly more traction, a timely interception by junior Nicholas Parisi sealed the win for the Falcons in the fourth quarter.
Up down the field, intercepted! Big play by Valley Stream. Nicholas.
Senior Yasir Shabazz-Ola was the engine for South's offense as he rushed for 251 yards and 3 touchdowns on 52 carries. The defense proved to be a nightmare for Hewlett as senior Malik Rowe had 11 tackles and junior Brandon Pierre added 8 more. Our girls soccer team was also busy on Friday as they hosted their senior game against Manhasset. Before the game commenced, the girls soccer team honored their seniors Haley Roberts, Caitlin Ross, and Janelia Fernandez, all three of which played key roles in winning the state championship 2 years ago. After the celebration of the seniors, the Falcons took the field against Manhasset. Although they fell short in the end, it was a great way to end a successful South career for these three seniors. And as we say goodbye to the fall sports season, it is also important to note that signups for spring sports are open on Family ID. The season begins next Thursday, April 22nd. And that's sports.
And as we leave you now, a glimpse of the girls' volleyball team clinching an undefeated conference championship this Wednesday. That's all for this edition of the Falcon Report. From our entire staff, stay safe and have a great weekend, Sal.